Dziękuję. What a great day to share ideas. Thanks for having me. It's a big honor. I dare to assume that most of us will agree that we need to get to a carbon-neutral economy and society as soon as possible. True? Maybe not. Okay. I think we do. And one of the major places to fight is energy. And Bill Gates, actually, at TED, not too long ago, was mentioning energy miracles. But I would like to challenge his focus a little bit, because the real miracle in renewable energy is not only will they get us to this carbon-neutral economy and create millions of jobs on the side, but with the decentralization, we're also able to democratize our energy structure. So today I'd like to talk to you about solar architecture, the integration of renewable energy into the buildings as the power plants of our future. Living EQUIA is a team of 40 students collaborating from different disciplines from different universities in Berlin. Our claim is living ecologic quality and the integration of ambience. And we're building a house that produces more energy than its inhabitants consume. It looks kind of like this. I don't have time to explain the whole thing. I'd just like to share one design feature with you, which is the two light axes, glass bands, running north, south, and east, west, opening the body and letting the sun in for a bleak sundial during the day, and enabling the building to radiate back into its environment at night. But the best part is it's not just us doing that from Berlin. But 20 universities from all over the world built their plus energy houses and then shipped them to Madrid this summer for a competition called the Solar Decathlon, where we have these 20 buildings aligned on Rio Manzanares. This will be ours down there in June. And for one hand, we want to educate the public about the potential of solar architecture and renewable energy. And we also want to foster innovation and compete in 10 different competition categories, from the design to the energy balance, how much do we produce, how much do we consume in this one week, and to the industrialization. This is us, despite the weather last month in Berlin. We're very excited that it's actually becoming a reality. But it's not only about us. We hope that we inspire and more people ask the question, how do we really want to live in the future? And is it able to give back to the environment and not just take from it? So Living EQUIA builds this house for the competition, which is what I'd like you to take home. Maybe next time we can have a Polish team at the competition, or even a German-Polish collaboration. Until then, please visit us online, spread the word, and keep your fingers crossed. I think it's Ciemac Czuki or something like that. Dziękuję bardzo. Oh, okay.
You're not going to get away that easy. I mean, this man's come from Berlin just to speak for 3 minutes. Come on. Give it up. The spirit of collaboration, of course, comes into this big time. You were saying that you had a team of 40. Can you maybe very quickly maybe touch on what Sergius was talking about and the recipe of how you've put it together?
The interesting collaboration part is that you have students of architecture and engineers and communication studies and everything else working together and trying to make this building a reality. And the most interesting part is actually having the architects and the construction engineers talk to the energy people. And the energy people say, hey, we need more solar panels here and there. And the architects say, hey, we need to integrate them into the facade, this dark facade, which is flamed wood, which is a very natural protection and also blends in. So this is kind of the trade-off we're trying to do and trying to show that it's actually possible with the technology that we have already to build these houses.
Outstanding. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.